NBC News has now confirmed that Michael Cohen has accepted a plea deal with prosecutors in the Southern District of New York. That explains that video that we saw just a few moments ago. This is about 1:45 this afternoon. Michael Cohen walking into a building in Manhattan that is the home to the FBI field office in New York. Now, the question will be, what are the terms of this plea deal? What exactly is Michael Cohen pleading to in terms of all the possible allegations out there against him? And what does it mean in terms of his potential cooperation with investigators in any case involving the President of the United States? We've been told by the White House that if we get any movement on a number of these fronts, that the White House generally will not comment on any of this. They'll refer everything to the outside lawyers. Nonetheless, we will go inside here and see if we can get the White House to offer their take on the significance of the president's former attorney now accepting a plea deal with prosecutors in Manhattan, Michelle.
And this plea deal, what do we know about what it might cover? In other words, as I understood it, and I may be taking you into an area that you can't answer, and I fully understand that, was that a lot of his legal jeopardy, such as it is or was, had to do with loans and the financing of taxi medallions and a taxi business that he owned with other family members.
Right. So we're in the realm of speculation here because we have not seen the plea deal. We haven't seen any documents around this. But among the allegations that have been swirling around Michael Cohen involve potential bank fraud and also potential campaign finance irregularities. Remember, there's been the accusations, or at least the possibility, that Michael Cohen was involved in payments to certain women for their silence, in exchange for their silence in the run-up to the 2016 elections, their silence about potential interactions that they had with then-candidate Donald Trump. By one reading of the law, you could argue that those were campaign-related payments, and therefore those should have been disclosed as campaign payments. So we don't know, ultimately, what he's going to plead to here, and so that's why we're going to be monitoring this very closely over the next couple of hours. We should get some documents here today that'll give us a sense of the lay of the land, and then more importantly, I think, for the larger picture, for the national picture, is what does it mean for the president and the legal case that might be building against him? So we'll wait and see what it is that Michael Cohen might have to tell prosecutors here.
All right.